Hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Am I clearly visible and audible to you people? Let me confirm it in 1 minute, then I will start the lecture. If I'm clearly visible, audible to you people, you can give me a thumbs up in the chat box. Okay, I hope I'm clearly visible and audible to you people now. So I welcome you all for today's session. I am Dr. Priyanka Sachdev here, Medical Entrance Educator on an Academy. So today I am here to continue my series for December FMG, targeting December FMG. So all those aspirants who are targeting this FMG should attend this series. Today I am taking, for the first lecture will be on microbiology. We have already started microbiology. We have started a lectures on general microbiology yesterday. Yesterday we have completed stains, the stains in microbiology, the various staining processes. We have completed the various staining processes. That is the classification of the stains: simple stain, negative stain, impregnation stain, and differential stain. We have already completed it. Those who have missed it can watch the recordings. In differential stain, we have completed Gram stain, acid pass stain, and Albert stain. So we have done the examples of each of them and the bacteria which is classified on the basis of them. We have completed it, and in the end we have done a special type of stain, that is bipolar safety pin appearance. I have given you numerous mnemonics based on staining. So today's topic, I'm starting with culture media. I will be a little bit faster. After culture media, I have to complete the growth curves and many other topics also. So let me start with culture media. What is culture media? In culture media, it can be a semi-solid or a liquid thing in which we grow bacteria. We provide nutrition to the bacteria for the growth of the organism. We are providing the nutrition. It can be liquid. It can be semi-solid. It can be in the form of a gel. So in both of them, I am providing nutrition to the bacteria. Why I am providing nutrition to the bacteria? This is my specimen. The test tube contains the specimen. Specimen can be blood, can be serum, can be urine, can be stool, can be saliva, can be CSF, can be anything. This can be any human body part. It is my specimen. The specimen in microbiology is known as inoculum. So this is my inoculum. I want to know whether it contains bacteria or do not contains bacteria. That is my question. If it contains bacteria, it is not visible to naked eye. The amount of bacteria, the number of bacteria inside it is very less. So what I will do, I will inoculate these bacteria on these culture media, whether liquid or solid. So I will put few drops of this specimen into my culture media and incubate it at 37 degrees Celsius inside an incubator. Like human body, I'm giving the temperature, adequate pH, and adequate nutrition. So if bacteria is present inside the specimen, inside the inoculum, they will divide, they will grow tremendously, and they will form multiple colonies here. The colonies will be visible to naked eye. So my diagnosis will be sure that yes, the specimen contains bacteria, or no, the specimen do not contain bacteria. So we will wait for 24 hours. After 24 hours, we will see the growth, whether the colonies are visible, whether the turbidity and colonies are visible, or whether they are not visible. After 24 hours, we will have a look on it. Yes. So that is the thing. And if the bacteria is present, then we will apply another test, the various biochemical reactions, to know which bacteria it is, to classify it. So this is how culture media are used. So that is the thing. So I have already told you, the specimen here is known as, the suspension of microorganism is known as inoculum. Usually all our specimens are liquid, that is blood, urine, saliva, CSF. Sometimes it is solid like stools. Then we make the saline suspension of the stool. So always inoculum is a suspension. It is a liquid thing. And inoculation is the process of introduction of the inoculum on the culture media. That is, and colony will be formed. Visible colonies is a group of bacteria which is visible on the surface of a solid culture media. And it is visible without microscope. So here you can see the colonies. We are doing the inoculation of the inoculum. And you can see multiple colonies. That is colony. Now basic constitution, all culture media contains these six things. We already know what are that is the basic constituents. All culture media contains these six things. Number one, water. Water is the source of hydrogen and oxygen, H2O, to the bacteria. We are providing water to the bacteria. We are providing NaCl, electrolyte, NaCl, salt, to the bacteria. So these culture media contains water. All of them contains water. They contains NaCl or electrolyte. Number three, they contain protein, partially digested protein, so that bacteria can easily consume it. It is not complete protein. These are partially digested protein. It comes in the form of a liquid water known as Peptone water. It is available commercially. Peptone water. So we use Peptone water also. We use meat extract. Meat extract. We use blood or serum. Blood or serum is not human blood. It is sheep blood. And it is 5 to 10% defibrillated blood. 5 to 10%. It doesn't contain fibrin. And last is agar. Last is agar. What is agar? What does agar provide? Water is providing H2O, HOH, hydrogen and oxygen. Electrolyte is providing NaCl. So what does agar provide? Agar doesn't provide anything. Agar does not have any nutritive value. There is no nutritive value in the agar. We give agar only to solidify it. The medium is liquid now. All the five things are liquid. Water is liquid, electrolyte is liquid, Peptone water is liquid, meat extract is liquid, and blood is liquid. We want to solidify it. To solidify it, we have to agent a solidifying agent. That is agar. Agar do not contain any nutritive value. Please remember it. It is only a solidifying agent. It is only a solidifying agent. Learn the percentage of agar. It is always 2 to 3%. We use 2 to 3% of agar. It is an MCQ. That's why I'm stressing it. Now learn the temperature. Agar melts at 98 degrees Celsius. Melting point of agar. And solidifies at 42 degrees Celsius. So agar solidifies at 42 degrees Celsius. And melting point is more important. Agar melts at 98 degrees Celsius. Room temperature never go 98. In summers, it may be maximum 45, 50. It is 45. It is not 98. Yes. So 98 degrees Celsius pe agar is melting. You have to learn it. It comes in powder form. It comes in powder form. And we have to add it in our liquid culture media so that it will solidify. That is about agar. And usually we use a special variety of agar known as New Zealand agar. New Zealand agar. It has a more jellifying capacity. So that is all about agar on which MCQs can come. One more important MCQ asked in your past paper exam, why agar is preferred as compared to gelatin? Gelatin is also a solidifying agent, no? Why we are not using gelatin? Because of the difference in melting point. Gelatin melts at 35 degrees. 35 degrees is our room temperature, no? So gelatin will melt, the cultured media will melt at room temperature. But agar melts at 98 degrees. So room temperature never goes. Room temperature never goes to 98 degrees. So if we use gelatin at room temperature, whenever room temperature is 35, it will melt. Gelatin will melt, but agar will not melt. So that is the reason, the difference in melting point. This is the answer of this MCQ. It is a MCQ which is already there in your past year exams. Now these are the basic constituents. Now let me tell you the classification of culture media. There are three classifications. Based on physical state, it is liquid, semi-solid and solid. Okay. Based on presence or absence of oxygen, it is aerobic and anaerobic. Today only I will tell you anaerobic media also. Robertson Cook media. It is an example of anaerobic media. We will come on it. And based on the nutrition, this is the classification. It is simple media, complex media, synthetic media and special media. All these are special media. We will take them one by one. The main is their examples. You have to learn three examples of each of them. It should be on the tip of your tongue. I will help you in learning. Don't worry, I will give you mnemonics also. So let me come on the simple media. Simple media is a media which do not contain anything extra. Only the basic constituents. You know what are basic constituents? Water, electrolyte, Peptone water. Only the basic constituents. That is simple media. No added ingredients. Nothing extra. No added ingredients. So two examples. In liquid, if you say, it is nutrient growth. In solid, if you say, it is nutrient agar. One and the same thing. So liquid nutrient growth. Contains Peptone water and meat extract. It contains water, HOH. It contains Peptone water and meat extract. These three things are present only. And if we add agar in this, the fourth thing, agar, it will become nutrient agar. So nutrient growth and nutrient agar is the most basic culture media available commercially. And they look yellowish in color, both of them. You can see it is liquid because it doesn't contain agar and it is semi-solid. You can say semi-solid because it contains agar. It is in the form of a gel. Agar is there. And both of them contains three things. Water, Peptone water and meat extract. Along with it, agar is present here and absent there. Give me a thumbs up. So two examples of simple media. Let me move ahead. Coming on complex media. All media except simple media are complex in which we add something special. Something special we add. Some special added ingredients we are adding. Why we are adding? Because some bacteria require specific growth nutrients. Like Haemophilus bacteria will not grow if you don't provide a factor 5, if you don't provide factor 10. So specific bacteria have specific growth requirements. It is like tantrum. I don't eat bhindi, someone don't eat bitter gourd. So it is like some bacteria requires this. No, I will prefer to eat this only. I will prefer to eat this only. So some bacteria prefer in their diet. So they prefer. So we have to add that special ingredient for the growth of that bacteria. If I am having a specimen, that is my inoculum, I am suspecting Haemophilus in that. So if I grow Haemophilus on any culture media, it will not grow basically on simple media. If you want to grow, you have to add factor 5 and factor 10. Then only it will grow. So that is the growth specification for Haemophilus. So for likewise, various bacteria have various growth specifications. So we have to add something special. So that we will add here in complex media. Then synthetic media. Synthetic media is not natural. It is made up of pure chemicals. And last is special media. We will talk about them one by one. There are 7 special media. Enriched media, enrichment. Most of the MCQs comes on this. Because of the spelling, most of the students get confused. What is enriched? What is enrichment? But there is a drastic difference between them. Enriched, enrichment, selective, differential, indicator, transporter, sugar. You have to learn examples of each of them. Again and again I am saying, MCQs will be on examples only. Done. Let me start the first one, enriched. Enriched media is that media in which we are adding three things, one of the three things. Apart from basic constitution, we are adding one of the three things, either blood or serum. Serum is a part of blood only, or egg. Blood, serum, or egg. So the bacteria which have more exact in their nutritional requirement, either they require blood for the growth, or they require serum for the growth, or they require egg for the growth. For them, I am adding this. So there are three examples. You have to learn three examples. Blood agar, in which we are adding blood. Chocolate agar, we are not adding chocolate. We are adding heated blood. When we heat the blood, here blood is red color. When we heat the blood, hemoglobin will come out. RBC will rupture, hemoglobin will come out, and that will be brown color. So brown color is like chocolate. And Loeffler serum slope, here we are adding serum. Here we are adding serum. See, this is blood agar in which we are adding blood. So it is red in color. Here we are adding heated blood. Heated blood. So it is becoming brown color. It is becoming brown color. It is known as chocolate agar. And here we are adding serum. We are adding serum. This is Loeffler serum slope. So you have to learn the name of the bacteria also. So Streptococcus require blood. Streptococcus cannot grow without blood. It requires blood for its growth. Neisseria requires heated blood, not blood. It requires heated blood. And Cornibacterium diphtheriae requires serum. So you have to learn the name of the bacteria also. So learn the name. Three markings are there. Learn the name of the media. What special ingredient you are adding in that media, and name the bacteria which require that media for their growth. So make a table and write the examples in your golden notebook. On the last day, you have to read only examples. You have made your golden notebook, right? Yes, if you are attending my lectures, you have to do. So that is the thing. So these are the three examples. Blood agar, chocolate agar. Blood agar, chocolate agar, chocolate agar, and Loeffler serum slope. These are the three examples of enriched media. Now let me come on the another media, enrichment. So this is, you compare the blood and chocolate color. Blood is red in color and chocolate is brown in color. Here we are adding blood only, and here we are adding heated blood. All these are MCQs, huh? I'm covering here. So that is done. Enriched media is done. Let me come on enrichment media. Enrichment media. Enriched is done. Now there is no relation. Only the spelling is same. There is no relationship. Enrichment media and enriched media. Enrichment and selective are same with each other. Enrichment. Enrichment media and selective media are almost same. Only difference is that enrichment media is liquid media. And selective media is solid media. So these two medias are comparative. The second and the third one are comparative with each other. So I will take these two media together. So three examples of each of them. But examples will be different. You have to learn examples. Done. So what do you mean by enrichment and selective media? So let me take a liquid media. This is a liquid media. It contains basic constituents. Let me take a solid media. It also contains basic constituents. Basic constituents, done. Now I want to grow a special bacteria. There is a bacteria. This is my inoculum. It contains the bacteria which I want to grow. But there is no pure thing. Na? If I take my saliva, if I take the blood, it along with that bacteria, it contains other bacteria also. It contains other small bacteria also. I do not want to grow these bacteria. I want to grow only this one. This is my required bacteria, preferential bacteria, which I want to grow here. And I do not want to grow other bacteria which are present in particular specimen or inoculum. So whenever I will do the inoculation of this specimen here, so all the bacteria will grow now. But I have to add something special then. I have to add something. So here in the media, I will add some special ingredients. Some special ingredients. What these ingredients will do? They will stimulate the growth of the bacteria which I require, and they will inhibit the growth of the bacteria which I do not require. So whenever I am adding these special ingredients which are stimulating the growth of the bacteria which I require and inhibiting the growth of other bacteria which I do not require, then these medias are known as, if it is liquid, it is known as enrichment media, and if it is solid, it is known as selective media. So one and the same thing. Have you got it? So what additional thing we are adding in the media apart from basic constitution? We are adding some special ingredients. Usually these are antibiotics. Some chemicals or antifungal drugs. So that will inhibit the growth of other bacteria and stimulate the growth of preferential bacteria. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I can see your chat. Yes, I can see your chat. Okay. So have you got it? So let me talk about first enrichment. Enriched ho gaya hai. Enriched mein only three things are there. Blood, egg and serum. We are adding three things. Blood, egg, serum. We are not adding antibiotics, antifungal. Here in both of them, we will add antibiotics and antifungal. Done. So let me talk about enrichment media first. Enrichment media is a liquid media. First learn it. Here we add certain substances which stimulate the growth of the bacteria which are to be grown and inhibit the growth of other bacteria, suppress the growth of other bacteria which we do not want to grow. So it has two effects, stimulatory effect on some bacteria, inhibitory effect on other bacteria, and we are adding it in a liquid media. So it is known as enrichment media. See the three examples. There are six, but three are more important. So these are the three. See, all of them are liquid. First, appreciate they are liquid. Appreciate. That's why they are known as enrichment. If they are solid, now the same thing is known as selective. So three examples are selenite F broth, tetrathionate broth, and alkaline peptone water. You have to learn. Tetrathionate broth, let me tell you. Tetrathionate broth. In tetrathionate broth, we grow only Salmonella species. No other bacteria will grow in it, because tetrathionate broth will inhibit all other bacteria except Salmonella. Only Salmonella will survive. All other bacteria will die. Selenite F broth contains selenite F. Only dysentery bacilli will survive. All other bacteria will die. And alkaline peptone water, only Vibrio cholerae will survive. All other bacteria will die. So say three examples. Tetrathionate broth, selenite F broth, and broth means water, liquid, and alkaline peptone water. So these are the three examples. Have you got it? These are the three examples. Have you got it, all of you? Should I proceed? These are the three examples. See, selenite F broth. In selenite F broth, only Salmonella will grow. No other bacteria will grow. So tell me the three examples of enriched media. Tell me three examples of enrichment. Then I will come on examples of selective. In selective, I have to tell you six examples. Instead of three, I have to tell you six examples. First, you have to learn the examples, na? Should I tell these six also? Do you want to revise these? In enriched media, there was blood agar, there was chocolate agar, and there was Loeffler serum slow. Yes, these are the three. Blood agar was Streptococcus. Chocolate was for, I just forgot. Chocolate kiske liye tha? Neisseria. And Loeffler serum slow was for Cornibacterium diphtheriae. Learn the name of the bacteria also. These are the three examples of enriched media. Enrichment mein, I told you tetrathionate broth, selenite F broth and alkaline peptone water. Alkaline peptone water for Vibrio cholerae, tetrathionate broth for Salmonella, and selenite F broth for dysentery bacilli. You have to learn the name of the bacteria also. I'm trying hard to make you learn. Give me a thumbs up. Should I come on the next media? Next media is selective. I have already told you the definition. It is a solid media. It is a solid media in which we are adding certain substances. Those substances have stimulatory effect on the bacteria which we want to grow and inhibitory effect on the bacteria which we do not want to grow. But it is solid. Instead of liquid, it is solid. Can you see? These are solid. These are plates. These are solid. These are solid media. These are not liquid. These are solid. These are solid. So tell me the examples. There are six examples. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We will see them one by one. So what are the examples? So first example is DCA. Learn the name. DCA, deoxycholate citrate, DCA is for Salmonella and Shigella. Only Salmonella and Shigella will survive, rest all bacteria will die. LJ media is for TB. McConkie media for E. coli. McConkie we already know for E. coli. LJ I hope you know for TB. And DCA, everyone knows it is for Salmonella and Shigella. These are selective media. The fourth is Thiermartin. Thiermartin is for gonorrhea. Thiermartin contains four things. Vancomycin kills all gram-positive bacteria. Colistin kills all gram-negative bacteria. These are antibiotics. Nystatin is an antifungal drug which kills all fungi. And trimethoprim again an antibiotic which kills all gram-negative bacteria, especially the proteas. So only gonorrhea will survive, rest all will die. So you should learn what it contains and what thing is killing which bacteria. Only gonorrhea will survive. So learn one thing, Thiermartin is for gonorrhea. Thiermartin is for gonorrhea. So DCA, LJ, McConkie, you have to learn. DCA, LJ, McConkie, Thiermartin. The fifth one is eosin methylene blue. It is only selective for gram negative bacteria. Methylene blue will kill gram positive, not gram negative. It will kill gram positive. The next is Campylobacter. So there are six examples. LJ, I have already told you. Can anyone of you tell me the six examples? What are the six examples of selective media? We will try to learn them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At least utna learn karo ki options mein dekhi click ho jaye. If you can't enumerate them, it's okay. It's okay. But options mein dekhi, you should click ki no, this is an example of selective media. So what are the examples who will help me in revising? The first was DCA, deoxycholate agar, DCA. The second was LJ. DCA was for Salmonella plus Shigella. LJ was for tuberculosis. The third was McConkie. McConkie was for E. coli. We all know McConkie, E. coli. Then last was Campylobacter. Campylobacter is for Campylobacter. This was methylene blue. Methylene blue was for gram negative bacteria. Gram positive will be killed. Gram negative, I just forgot this name. What was it? Thiermartin. Thiermartin was for gonorrhea. It was for gonorrhea. So learn the name of the media and learn the name of the specific bacteria which can grow on this media. This is how questions can be framed. And if you are more a very studious student, you can learn the composition of these media also, that it contains what that is killing other bacteria, not this bacteria. So you can learn the composition if you wish. I have told you the composition of Thiermartin in detail, in which questions are already asked in the past year exams. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone of you, I want thumbs up from all of you. Those who are listening, I want thumbs up from each of you so that I can proceed ahead. Should I proceed? Should I come on the next thing? So it is DCA, LJ, McConkie, Thiermartin, methylene blue and Campylobacter. Try to learn. Okay, coming on the fourth thing, that is differential media. We are done with enriched. You know the three examples of enriched. We are done with enrichment. You know the three examples of enrichment. Done. You know the six examples of selective. Now I'm coming on differential. Oh no, I'm coming on indicator first, then I will come on differential. So indicator media, very easy. Indicator media contain some indicator in it, so that whenever bacteria grows in it, color change occur. So this is a culture media. Whenever I am putting my inoculum on it, so the bacteria will grow on it, but bacteria will not be visible to naked eyes. So unless until bacteria will form the big colonies, then only it will be visible by naked eyes. But initial to that, whenever bacteria will start growing before colonies, color change will occur. And with the help of that color change, I will come to know that yes, bacteria is present in the inoculum. That's why bacteria start growth, and growth of bacteria is causing the color change. So indicator is indicating to us. So that is the indicator. There are, I guess, two examples of indicator. You have to learn for your academic purpose. Wilson and Blair, it will change color from green to black. Black color will be there, and it is for Salmonella typhi. When Salmonella typhi will grow, then only color change will occur. Otherwise, color change will not occur. And Macleoid is for Cornibacterium diphtheria. I will show you both. So can you see the two examples, Wilson and Blair and Macleoid? Okay, I will tell you. This is the Wilson and Blair. You can see the black color colonies are there. Black color dots are there. I will mark with red. Can you see the black color dots? Black. So here, the color of the colonies, this is Macleoid. No, this is Wilson and Blair. Wilson and Blair is for Salmonella typhi. It forms black colonies. And Macleod is for diphtheria. It also forms black colonies. Both of them have black colonies. Black colonies. What is the name of the indicator in each of them? Which is forming these black colonies? Name of indicator. Okay, I told you Wilson and Blair is for Salmonella typhi. Learn the bacteria for which it is specific. Done. It contains sulfite. When Salmonella typhi growth occurs, sulfite changes to sulfide. Sulfite changes to sulfide, which is giving, which is this sulfide in presence of glucose will give a black color. That's why the colonies are black color. Again, a very important MCQ. So what is the indicator? Indicator is sulfite. On growth of bacteria, this sulfite will get converted into sulfide, which gives a black color. Learn it. That is about Wilson Blair. Coming on Macleod. Macleod contains tellurium. Tellurium. You can see potassium telluride. It contains potassium telluride. On the growth of diphtheria, this potassium telluride will get converted into tellurium, which gives black color. Give me a thumbs up. Okay, I will summarize again. Wilson Blair and Macleod. Macleod. Wilson Blair. Name the bacteria first for which it is important. Name the bacteria. Wilson Blair is for Salmonella typhi. And Macleod. Macleod is for Cornibacterium diphtheriae. Learn the name of the bacteria. Now tell me the indicator which is present in each of them. Color. Tell me the color. Color is black in both of them. Learn the name of the color also. Indicator. In Wilson Blair, the indicator is telluride, which get converted into telluride when growth occurs. And here it contains sulfide to sulfide. It contains sulfide to sulfide. Okay, I have to take another sheet. In Wilson Blair, it contains sulfite to sulfide. This is the thing. And Macleod, it contains potassium telluride to metallic telluride. Both of these are giving black color when they are formed. Black color. Here Salmonella will grow, Salmonella typhi. Here Cornibacterium will grow, then this conversion. So here conversion is occurring from sulfite to sulfide when Salmonella is growing. Here conversion from potassium telluride to telluride is occurring when Cornibacterium is growing. And both of them, color of colony is black. So any MCQ can be framed on it. Learn the name of the media first. Wilson Blair and Macleod. Give me a thumbs up. So this is how MCQs will be framed. Now many MCQs, at least 5 MCQ can be framed from this slide. So name, first name the media, name the color, name the indicator, name the bacteria. You should know everything. Should I move ahead? So sulfite changes to sulfide, and here that is giving the black color in Wilson Blair. I have already told you. So that was about indicator media. I have told you 2 examples in indicator media, Wilson Blair media, and the second was Wilson Blair media and Macleod media. Macleod. So learn. Yeah, I know it is difficult to learn the names. You will say, ma'am, how many names should I learn? In enriched media, there were 3 examples: blood, chocolate, and Loffler's serum slope. These were the 3. Enrichment, there were 3 liquid medias. The 2 were broth. Selenite F broth. I just forgot what was the another broth. And there was alkaline peptone water. These were the 3 liquid media. In selective media, I have told you 6 examples of the solid media. I am not enumerating again. In indicator media, I have told you only 2 examples. Wilson Blair and Macleod. Let me come on differential media now. The 5th one is the differential media. As the name indicates, it will give different color to different bacteria. That's why known as differential. Different color to different bacteria. So it incorporates, it contains a substance which differ out the characteristics of bacteria, thus helping us to distinguish between the bacteria. So it gives different color to different bacteria, that substance. So you have to learn the examples, of course. So there will be 3 examples, I guess. Let me see. 3. Yes, 3 examples are there. So number 1 is McConkie. Most important is McConkie media. Now here it contains neutral rat. McConkie media contains neutral rat. So there are 2 types of bacteria. It contains lactose also. This is McConkie media. It contains lactose. So whenever I put my bacteria over it, this is my bacteria. See, this is my bacteria. So my bacteria can be lactose fermenter. My bacteria cannot be lactose fermenter. It can ferment lactose. It cannot ferment. It depends. If the bacteria is lactose fermenter, it will ferment lactose, and because of neutral red, which is present in the media, they will become pink color. They will form pink color colonies. And if it is lactose non-fermenter, they will form yellow color colonies. So pink and yellow. Pink and pale. Pale means yellow. Yellow colonies. So lactose fermenter. Can you see? A beautiful diagram. Beautiful. Lactose fermenter are forming pink colonies. And lactose non-fermenter, non-lactose fermenter are forming colorless or yellow colonies. Whatever you say. It is due to lactose, of course. Lactose to hai. It is due to neutral red. Neutral red present in the media. So question can come on anything. Give me a thumbs up. Neutral red. Have you got it? Neutral red. So some bacteria, just suppose E. coli is a lactose fermenter. It is forming pink colonies. Enterobacter aeruginase. It is also a lactose fermenter. But Proteus is lactose non-fermenter. Salmonella is lactose non-fermenter. Staphylococcus is lactose non-fermenter. So you can see some bacteria are lactose fermenter. Some bacteria are non-lactose fermenter. When I will teach you all 30 bacteria one by one. So in biochemical reactions, I will give you a column lactose. So you have to put positive or negative. Salmonella, Shigella, E. coli, Staphylococcus, Streptococcus. So which bacteria are lactose fermenter, which are lactose non-fermenter, you have to learn it one by one. Or in the end, I will give you a mnemonic for the bacteria which ferment lactose. Done? Have you got it? What will be the trick? So that is lactose. How lactose fermentation and non-fermentation is identified? On McConkey. McConkey agar. It contains neutral red. Neutral red is the name of the chemical. So when lactose fermentation takes place, this neutral red converts into pink color. And when lactose fermentation do not take place, this neutral red gives yellow color. So that is the differentiating media. Have you got it? So some bacteria are taking pink color, some bacteria are taking yellow color. That's why it is an example of differential media. Different bacteria having different colors, different growth characteristics. Give me a thumbs up. So the first example, McConkey, sabko acche se samajh mein aa gaya. Second example is xylose, lysine deoxycholate. In short, it is known as XLD. Xylose, learn the full forms also. Xylose, lysine deoxycholate media. So it is for Salmonella and Shigella. Recovery of Salmonella and Shigella. So see here, E. coli and Salmonella Shigella, all of them are gram-negative bacilli. Na? They all present together. Usually in specimen, they all present together. So if you want to differentiate what is present, whether E. coli is present or Salmonella Shigella is present. So if you grow them on this media, then E. coli will form yellow colonies and Salmonella Shigella will form black colonies. So can you see here? Okay. Can you see in this diagram? See, try to see the diagram. Some colonies are yellow color. Say yes or no. These yellow color colonies are of E. coli. And some colonies are black color. Yes or no. These black color colonies are Salmonella Shigella. Give me a thumbs up. So black and yellow. Black colonies will be Salmonella and Shigella. Yellow colonies will be E. coli. It contains xylose, lysine and deoxycholate in it. Give me a thumbs up. Again, a differential media, different colors, different bacteria, differential media, XLD. The first was McConkey. McConkey differentiates lactose fermenters from lactose non-fermenters. XLD differentiates Salmonella Shigella from rest of the gram-negative bacilli. Salmonella Shigella ke liye specific hai. Salmonella Shigella form black colonies. Rest of the bacteria forms yellow colonies. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. I'm really trying hard. The third is TCBS. Many MCQs come from this topic. TCBS. What is the full form of TCBS? T is thiosulfate, citrate, bile salt sucrose. S is bile salt. Okay, bile salt ek hi hai. Sucrose. So thiosulfate, citrate, bile salt, sucrose. TCBS. In short, it is known as TCBS. So it is highly selective for Vibrio. Vibrio coleri and Vibrio parahemolyticus. So Vibrio yellow colored colonies by Vibrio. So Vibrio only form yellow colored colonies here. No other bacteria will form yellow colored colonies. Rest of the bacteria will form black colored colonies. So here yellow colonies by Vibrio. So that is how, that is an example of indicator media. So in indicator media, I have told you, no, sorry, not indicator. Differential media, I have told you three examples. What are the three examples? Of course, the first example everyone knows, McConkey. McConkey is the pink and yellow. McConkey, lactose fermenter and lactose non-fermenter. Second is XLD. XLD is for Salmonella Shigella, differentiating it from rest of the gram-negative bacilli. And third was TCBS. TCBS is for Vibrio. It is for Vibrio. We have to separate the Vibrio from rest of the bacteria. It is for Vibrio. Vibrio will form yellow colonies. Here, Salmonella Shigella will form black colonies. And in McConkey, lactose fermenter will form pink. Lactose non-fermenter will form yellow. So this is how we are differentiating the bacteria. Different bacteria, different color. Give me a thumbs up that these are the examples of Differential media, indicator media. I have already told you two examples. What were they? Let me think. Indicator media. I just forgot. Indicator media mein kya the? Wilson Blair and MacLeod, right? No, Wilson Blair and MacLeod hi tha na indicator mein. In indicator media, yes, I'm right. Wilson Blair and MacLeod. It is an indicator media. So two examples of indicator I have told you. Wilson Blair and MacLeod. Wilson Blair contains sulfide to sulfide. And MacLeod contains potassium telluride to telluride, sulfide to sulfide, telluride to telluride. So that is how both of them are black color and black color. Give me a thumbs up everyone. So these are the, and you know the name of the bacteria also. You already know the examples of enrichment and selective. Say the examples again. Don't say only example, uski detail bhi bolo. Wo example mein jo culture media hai, for which bacteria, name the bacteria also, which is specific for that growth. Name the color also, name the chemical also. MCQ can come on any point. Coming on the last media, transport media. I will show you the MCQs now in the form of the polls now. Okay. Coming on the last, sugar, I will not teach you. It is not very important. Transport media. What do I mean by transport media? Now, some organisms, some bacteria are very delicate. They are very delicate. And most of the time, you know, sometimes home collection of the specimen takes place. Nowadays it is trending. Most of the patient do not come to the hospital. They already know hospital is the infective place. We don't go to the hospital. Call a technician at the home only. They will collect our sample at home. That is home collection. So if some person is giving home collection of the specimen, so specimen has to reach the laboratory as soon as possible because this specimen contains bacteria. So if the transit time is more, the bacteria can die in the transit only. So whenever specimen reach the lab, there is no bacteria in it and we will give a false report. It will be a false report. It is not a true report that the specimen do not contain any bacteria. It is not showing any growth, but it is not the fact. Actually, the specimen contains the bacteria, but during the transport, the bacteria was delicate and it is dead. So it we to the technicians, we will give some special media known as transport media. They will collect the sample in that media only, so that on the way also, on the transit time, on the transport time, whatever hours, 3 hours, 2 hours, maybe whatever hours it is taking for transport, the bacteria will not die. It will get some nutrition in that transport media, so it will not die on reaching the lab. And on reaching the laboratory, we will inoculate it on the culture plate. We are not giving culture plate to the technician. We are giving some liquid media so that the sample can be collected in that, so that during the transit time, bacteria is not dying. Done during the transit time. Give me a thumbs up. As the name indicated, it's transport media. So transport media are the media. They are used in case of delicate organism, not for all organism. Very delicate organism, example, gonococci, and which may not survive the time taken for the transit or overgrown by other bacteria. During the transit, either they will die or other bacteria are also present in the specimen. Na? In specimen, not single bacteria, other bacteria is also present. These are so delicate that other bacteria will overgrow it. So during on reaching the lab, we will find the abundant growth of other bacteria, not this bacteria. So this bacteria will die during the transit. So we use transport media for them. So name them. There are six transport media. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 6, 7 medias are there. So learn the names. Learn the names. Examples are more important than definition. So definition to naam mein hidden hai, transport media for transport. So this is transport media for stool specimen. All of these causes diarrhea, dysentery and diarrhea. All these bacteria. So Carrie-Blair media is for enteric bacteria. All enteric bacteria like E. coli. Stuart amines again for enteric bacteria, Buffered glycerol saline again for enteric bacteria except Vibrio and Campylobacter. Alkaline peptone water for Vibrio. And VR is the name of the scientist who has discovered it. Venkatesh Raman. That is VR media. It's for Vibrio. So you have to learn the name. So Stuart media, VR media, glycerine, buffered saline. You have to learn the names. Have you got it? Should I move ahead? Isme se do hi Vibrio ke liye hain. How you will learn? Alkaline peptone water and VR media. That is for Vibrio. And rest all are for other enteric bacteria apart from Vibrio. That is Salmonella, that is Shigella, that is E. coli. That is Proteus, you know, other enteric bacteria. Give me a thumbs up. That is transport media. Should I move ahead? Have you got it? Do you know the example of all of them? So I will launch the polls in the after that. Yeah, these all are aerobic medias. Aerobic media, because you know the culture plate is open. open in the air, and air contains oxygen. So these all are aerobic media, but some bacteria do not grow in presence of oxygen. They are strictly anaerobic. So you cannot grow anaerobic bacteria on these culture growths. For that, you have to frame another media, which is known as anaerobic media, for the growth of strict anaerobic bacteria. Yesterday I gave you the mnemonic for anaerobic bacteria. Strict anaerobes are only three: can't breathe air. That was the mnemonic. You know the full form. You know the full form, can't breathe air ka full form kya hai, you already know. These are strict anaerobes. You cannot grow these three bacteria on open culture plates. So this is my culture plate. This can be any agar. You cannot grow these bacteria on these agar because it is present in air. Air contains oxygen. In presence of oxygen, they will not grow. So we have three specific media which are for the growth of anaerobic bacteria. Name them. First name them, then I will give you the details. Name them. So Robertson cooked meat broth. So RCM, some says RCM, Robertson cooked meat, or some say CMB, that is cooked meat broth. Whatever it is, in some books it is RCM written, in some books CMB written. So whatever you say, it is Robertson cooked meat broth. It is an anaerobic media. Second is thioglycolate. Learn it, thioglycolate. And third is Smith-Nagoji. Out of these three, I will teach you two. The first two in detail. I will teach you Robertson, very, very, very important. I will teach you in detail. And thioglycolate, I will teach you in detail. Smith-Nagoji, you just learn the name. I will not teach you in detail. So that are the three examples. Learn three examples first. Anaerobic media, I am teaching you. Give me a thumbs up, everyone. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Anaerobic media. So these are the diagrams. Robertson cooked media. It is a liquid media. It is a liquid media. I will tell you the composition. It contains meat pieces at the bottom. Meat pieces. Meat pieces. Pieces of the meat at the bottom, and a liquid media. And at the top, you can see this is a vacuum all around. Huh? This is not oxygen. And at the top, the test tube is packed with paraffin wax. Paraffin wax so that air do not enter inside. New air do not enter inside, and the air which is already present in the test tube is consumed. And here is vacuum. We have created the vacuum. Now we will grow the specimen or inoculum inside it for the anaerobic. How we create, I will tell you. And this is thioglycolate broth. Again, it is also a broth. Broth means liquid. So I will tell you both. Just a second. Let me talk about the first thing. Robertson cooked meat, RCM. RCM broth. So it is a nutrient broth. You know the most basic broth, nutrient broth. Nutrient broth, and along with the pieces of meat, cooked meat from the ox heart. You know ox is an animal, ox ka heart. When we will kill the ox, we will take the heart out. We will take the heart out and we will cut it into multiple small. We will mince small pieces. We will cook the meat and then we will put it in the nutrient broth. So take a nutrient broth and put some pieces of the ox heart into it, meat into it. I will call it as meat pieces, cooked meat. You have to cook it first, huh? Cooked meat pieces into it. And then pack the test tube on the top with paraffin wax. As I have told you, you have to pack it here so that no fresh air enters inside. So this will be the, you have to paraffin. You have to take sterile paraffin, yes, to pack it. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Now how vacuum is created, I will tell you. Inside it, vacuum will be created. Why? You will say, ma'am, what is there? Something is there. Three things are present in the meat that will create vacuum inside it. Three things are present in the meat. I will tell you all three. These are the three things. The meat, ox meat, contains three things that will produce vacuum inside. Number one, it contains fatty acid, unsaturated fatty acid. The present in the meat, it will utilize all the oxygen present in the test tube for auto-oxidation, and this reaction is catalyzed by hemine, which is already present in meat. So meat mein hi fatty acid hai, meat ke andar hi hemine hai. Hemine is acting as a catalyst, and these fatty acids are using the oxygen for their self-oxidation. Are you getting me? So this is the test tube. This is the nutrient broth inside it. This is the nutrient broth. These are the meat pieces inside it. Meat pieces. These meat pieces contain three things. One, two, three. I will tell you all. And you are covering the top of the test tube with a paraffin wax. Right? So that no fresh air or oxygen enters inside. Now the thing is, the oxygen which is already present in the space, you have to consume it for creating vacuum here. So how we are creating vacuum here to produce an anaerobic environment, that will be done by the meat pieces. Meat pieces contain three things that will help us in creating this vacuum. Number one, it contains unsaturated fatty acid. These fatty acid will utilize this oxygen for and create the vacuum. They will auto-oxidize in presence of hemin. Hemin is already present in the meat. That is the first thing. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Second is glutathione and cysteine. These are the amino acids which are already present in the meat. They also utilize oxygen and create the vacuum. Glutathione and cysteine. The second thing is glutathione plus cysteine. First was fatty acid. These were utilizing oxygen. Second are glutathione and cysteine. These are also utilizing oxygen. So more and more, more oxygen is utilized, and vacuum is created there in the space in the test tube. And no pressure is entering. So vacuum is created. Done. So glutathione and cysteine is the second thing. Third thing is sulfahydryl compounds. Sulfahydryl compounds present in the cysteine, also in the meat. They also do the redox reactions. You know, oxidation reduction reactions. So third is not really very important, but you can learn it. It is sulfahydryl compounds. So unsaturated fatty acid. Just a second. I'm sorry. Okay. Yeah. So unsaturated fatty acid, glutathione and cysteine, and sulfahydryl compounds. These three things are utilizing oxygen from the test tube and producing vacuum in the test tube. All these three things are present in the meat. So that's why meat pieces are really very important. And we have covered the top with a paraffin wax so that no new air can enter. Give me a thumbs up. So what actually we have to do, we have to take the test tube. We have to fill the test tube. Okay, let me take another one. We have to take the test tube. We have to fill the test tube with nutrient broth. And at the bottom, we have to put some meat pieces. And we have to cover it with paraffin wax at the top so that no fresh air enters inside it. After that, we have to heat it. After that, we have to heat it in water bath. I will tell you exact temperature in the next slide. We have to heat it in a water bath so that the three things which are present inside this meat will start at that temperature at heating. They will start utilizing the oxygen present in the test tube that will be utilized by the meat pieces. Number one, unsaturated fatty acid. Number two, glutathione plus cysteine. Number three, sulfahydryl compounds. These three things are present in the meat. They will utilize all the oxygen, and here vacuum will be created and no new oxygen is entering. You have packed it very, very clearly. You have sealed it. So no new oxygen will be entering, and the previous oxygen is already utilized by meat. Done. So that is how we have created an anaerobic medium. This is known as Robertson, because the scientist who have created it is the name of scientist. Robertson. Cooked meat. We are using cooked meat, and it is a broth, nutrient broth. Robertson, cooked meat broth. Give me a thumbs up. I really tried my best. So that is the principle. On principle, many questions come. How you are creating the vacuum? What are the things present in the meat pieces that will create the vacuum? Done. And you have to boil it in water bath at 80 degree for 30 minutes so that meat pieces can utilize all the oxygen and make it oxygen free. So you have to learn the temperature also, my diagram. So here you have to heat it in water bath for 80 degree for 30 minutes. 80 degree, 30 minutes. Learn it. Question can come on anything. And at the top, there is a sterile liquid paraffin for no new oxygen. So what will happen? What will happen? This is the thing. So what will happen when you are putting your inoculum inside it? Your inoculum, it contains bacteria. It contains anaerobic bacteria basically. For anaerobic bacteria, ke liye to itna tamjham kar rahe hain. Anaerobic bacteria. It contains anaerobic bacteria. Now, anaerobic bacteria are of two types. Some of them are saccharolytic and some of them are proteolytic. Saccharolytic, lytic means degradation. They will degrade the carbohydrates. Saccharo means sugar. Sugar, carbohydrate. Carbohydrate degrade karenge. And some of them are proteolytic. They will degrade the protein. So they are of two types. Saccharolytic. And proteolytic. Saccharolytic and proteolytic. So the anaerobic bacteria which are saccharolytic and some of them are proteolytic. Saccharolytic will give red color to the meat pieces. After some time, the color of the meat pieces will become red. And if it is proteolytic, the color of the meat pieces will become black after some time. Will black. Here you can see the black color. These are proteolytic in this diagram. I didn't got the diagram for saccharolytic. Learn the colors. So saccharolytic, red color. Let me confirm. Yes, saccharolytic is red color. And proteolytic is black color. That is the color of meat pieces. Meat pieces ka color change ho jayega thodi der ke baad. So double advantage. So Robertson cooked meat broth, if I take, it contains nutrient agar. It contains meat pieces at the bottom. It contains paraffin at the top. When I put my inoculum inside it, my bacteria inside it. Now my bacteria, whether it is saccharolytic or proteolytic. So color change of the meat will tell me. If the red color meat pieces, then it is saccharolytic. If black color meat pieces, it is proteolytic. So it is doing double advantage. Number one, it is providing anaerobic media to my bacteria. Number one, of course, that is important. And second, it is acting as a differential media for the two types of anaerobic bacteria. It is giving different color to different bacteria. So it is also an example of differential media, red and black color to saccharolytic and proteolytic respectively. Give me a thumbs up. And you know the principle, what three things are present inside this meat, which will utilize the oxygen from here and create vacuum here. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Those who are listening, everyone give me a thumbs up. I really tried hard. So MCQs can come on any of these. That was the first example of anaerobic media. The second example of anaerobic media is thioglycolate broth. Actually, it is used to differentiate whether the bacteria is aerobic or anaerobic. You have to tell me, I don't know, this is my bacteria, this is my specimen, this is my inoculum, it contains bacteria. I don't know whether the bacteria is aerobic or it is anaerobic. I can grow it on thioglycolate broth, then I will come to know whether it is aerobic or anaerobic. So what is this broth? So you can see this is the broth, it is like this. So whenever you put your bacteria inside it and colonies are formed at the top, the bacteria are gathering at the top of the test tube. Okay, let me see, just a second. The bacteria are gathering at the top of the test tube are the bacteria which requires the oxygen at high concentration. So these are strict aerobes, obligate aerobes. Can you see the bacteria are only at the top? They are not at the bottom. Why? Because here is the air. They are utilizing oxygen from the air. So they will form colonies only, they will grow only at the top of the test tube, not at the bottom. These are strict obligate aerobes. These are obligate aerobes. Give me a thumbs up. See the second test tube. Here the bacteria are growing at the bottom, away from the oxygen, much away from the oxygen. They do not want oxygen. So which bacteria are these? You only tell me. These are obligate and aerobes. In presence of oxygen, there is toxicity to them. So they do not like oxygen. They are obligate and aerobes. So these are obligate. The second is obligate anaerobes. They will grow at the lowest point. Obligate aerobes will grow at the top. Obligate anaerobes will grow at the bottom. They will gather at the bottom because oxygen concentration is minimum at the bottom. The fourth one, microaerophilic. They require oxygen, but at low concentration, not at high concentration. So they will be present here. Can you see? They will be present here. Microaerophilic. Not at the top, just below that. So they need oxygen, but not in high concentration, at low concentration. So they will ferment, respire anaerobically. However, they are poisoned in presence of high concentration. So they will gather at the upper part. They will gather only at the upper part, not at the lower part. So these are microaerophilic. Done. Ek aur test tube bacha hai, 3 number. Let me see what is this 3 number. These are facultative anaerobes. What do you mean by that? You will ask, ma'am, obligate anaerobes or facultative mein kya difference? What is the difference between obligate and facultative? Obligate means strict. These are strict and these are chalega. Like chalega, anaerob hoga to zyada better hai, nahi hoga to aerobically bhi grow kar lenge. They are not very specific. They prefer to become anaerobic. But if anaerobic is not there, they will not die. They will us aerob se bhi kaam chala lenge. In presence of oxygen, they will also survive. And obligate anaerobes will die in presence of oxygen. They are very strict. They grow only in absence of oxygen. Have you got it? So these are facultative anaerobes. So facultative anaerobes gather everywhere. You can see they are gathering everywhere throughout the test tube. Give me a thumbs up. So these are facultative aerobe ki anaerobe. Facultative anaerobe. Give me a thumbs up, everyone of you. Give me a thumbs up. So this is thioglycolate broth, which is differentiating the four categories of the bacteria. We have four types of bacteria. What are the four types of the bacteria? You tell me. We have strict aerobes, that is obligate aerobes. We have strict anaerobes, that is obligate anaerobes. We have facultative anaerobes. They prefer oxygen, but without oxygen also they will survive. And we have microaerophilic organisms. So based on oxygen requirement, organisms are of four types. based on oxygen requirement. The one which grow only in presence of oxygen, in absence of oxygen they die, they are known as obligatorous. The one which grow in absence of oxygen, in presence of oxygen they will die, they grow only in absence of oxygen. So they require oxygen, they do not require oxygen. These are known as obligate anaerobes. The third one prefer anaerobically, but in presence of oxygen also they survive. These are known as facultative. And the fourth one require oxygen, but in lower concentration, not in high concentration. These are known as microaerophilic. So where they are growing in thioglycolate growth, where the growth is occurring, you have to tell me the growth. You have to tell me the pattern of the growth, where they are growing. So aerobes will grow at the top. Anaerobes will grow at the bottom. Facultative anaerobe will grow throughout. And microaerophilic just below the top. Give me a thumbs up. I really tried my best to help you in explaining the concepts. So you will never forget. No need of learning. You got the concept now. There is no need of learning. So that is thioglycolate broth. Third was Smith-Nagouchi. I'm not giving explanation of it. We are done with anaerobic media. Robertson-Cook media bhi dekh liya. Thioglycolate bhi dekh liya. So we have seen it. Now one more thing, swarming growth. Before ending the chapter, I would like to tell you swarming growth. What is swarming growth? Those who are available on my Telegram group channel, on my WhatsApp, I will share you a small animated video on that. Today only I will share showing the swarming growth. Actually, swarming growth is seen only in motile bacteria. Name the motile bacteria. You know the name of the motile bacteria. So yesterday only I have told you mnemonics for motility of the bacteria. So you should know the mnemonic for motile bacteria. So swarming growth is due to motility of the bacteria. So the bacteria which are motile, which are very rapidly motile, they will form circles in concentric circles or dendritic circles. You know, you can see here concentric. Here, what I am doing, listen. So this is my culture media. This is the center of my culture media. So I'm putting my bacteria here at the center. I'm just putting my specimen at the center. As soon as I'm putting the specimen, one drop of the specimen at the center, I will see with naked eye, without microscope, I will see some circles are forming. Rapidly circles are forming here. Or else, the second thing can happen like this. Let me take another slide. Second thing, I'm putting here at the center one drop. So immediately after that, this type of growth. This type of waves, not growth, it is not growth, these are waves. So I can see the waves either concentrically or dendritically. Dendritic pattern. So I appreciate the both patterns. This is concentric pattern here. These are the waves. You can see the waves. As soon as you will put the specimen, you can see the waves. And this is dendritic pattern. So concentric and dendritic are the two. I will show you a video, a very good video. So dendritic pattern, it is seen visibly. If you have seen in your labs, I don't know. If you see it, you will never forget. So this is due to motility of the bacteria. As soon as you are putting the specimen at the center, bacteria start moving. So rapidly it is moving, either in the form of circles or dendritically. So that is due to highly motile, fast moving bacteria. So name the bacteria which shows this motility. So can you see it is concentric here? It is waves. And can you see it is dendritic here? Dendritic. Give me a thumbs up. So name some fast moving bacteria. Motility to bahut thi. Kal maine tumhe do mnemonic bataye the. Motility for Peritrichus flagella and motility for polar flagella. Two mnemonics yesterday I have told you. The first mnemonic was cute baby sleeping was there. And second mnemonic was very strong solution. Very protective solution, HCl. So that was for polar. Yes or no? Say yes or no. Fast. So you have to say. So you should know what is this P. Dono mein P kya hai aur kya. You know the full forms. All these bacteria are motile. I agree. But which of them are fastest? The fastest motile. They will only show swarming. They will show swarming. Swarming is not shown by all of them. So few of them will show swarming. Give me a thumbs up if you are getting it. So name them. So from gram positive bacteria, there are two. Clostridium tetani, not all Clostridium, and Bacillus cirrus. It is not Bacillus anthrax. It is Bacillus cirrus. It is not Clostridium perfringens. It is Clostridium tetani. I am very specific, specifically telling you because your option contains other Clostridium also, other Bacillus also. Main Bacillus anthrax hota hai. Wo nahi dikhata. Main Clostridium perfringens hota hai. Wo nahi dikhata. These are two other Bacillus and Clostridium. From gram negative, it is Proteus mirabilis and Proteus vulgaris. So Proteus mirabilis and Proteus vulgaris, from gram positive, gram negative, learn the names. They only show swarming growth because of rapid, ultra fast mortality. They just run. And because of their running, waves are created on the culture media, which is visible by naked eye. So I will share a video there. If you are not available, be available there and please have a look on the video. So I'm done with it. I would like to launch few polls, but my time is over. Okay, be fast. Be fast. Write your answer in the chat box, but fast, huh? I will not give you much time. This is the first question in front of you. Be fast. The chapter is done. Which is enrichment media among the following? Who will tell me the name of the enrichment media? Fast. Fast. Which among the following is the enrichment media? Enrichment is a liquid media which contains something extra, which either stimulate the bacteria or inhibit the other bacteria. So what is the correct answer? Yes, you all are right. The correct answer here is A. Selenite F proof. Yes. Selenite. Meat extract is the anaerobic media. Chocolate and egg are the enriched media. Enriched, not enrichment. Enriched media ke examples hai ye. So the correct example among them is A. The next question is in front of you. Next question. You all are right. Very good. I'm proud of you. The next question is chocolate agar is an example of. Very easy. Baby question. You know everyone is right. Chocolate agar. Chocolate agar do not contain chocolate. It contains heated blood. So it is an example of course, enriched. Not enrichment. It is an example of enriched. Enriched media are the media which contains blood, heated blood or serum. These three things or egg. These four things are present in enriched media. So these are the examples. So the correct answer again is A. Yes, blood agar, chocolate agar, Loftus serum slope. Yes, the correct answer is A. You all are right. I don't have time to announce the names, but you all are right. This is the next question. Blood agar is an example of, again a baby question, same question, baby question. So blood agar contains blood. Is it an example of enrichment or enriched? You always got confused between the two. So again, it is an example of enriched media. Yes, the same concept. Same concept. McConkie agar is an example of McConkie. McConkie, lactose fermenter, pink color, and lactose non-fermenter, yellow color. Remembering? So it is differentiating the two bacteria. Lactose fermenter obtained pink color, lactose non-fermenter obtained yellow color. So it is a differential media. Remembering, this is pink and yellow. So different color to different bacteria. Yes, the correct answer is C. You all are right. Very good. This is the next question. Loftus medium is an example of. I have told you all MCQs will be on examples only. Learn examples. Isliye to bol rahi thi. Now see, Loftus serum slope contains serum. Loftus contains serum. So it is an example of enriched media. Enriched media contains blood, serum and egg. So it is an example of enriched media. So Loftus serum slope contains serum. Have you remembered? Yes, you all are right. Very good. Correct answer is D. In nutrient agar, what is the concentration of agar? When I have told you, agar do not have any nutritious value. It only acts as a solidifying agent. What is the concentration you use there? Yes, the concentration we use here is 2%. Learn the concentration. It is 2%. All of the following are examples of enriched media except. Question contains except. So yes, who will tell me the answer? Blood agar contains blood. Chocolate agar contains heated blood. Loftus serum slope contains serum. But bile salt agar is not an example of enriched media. It is not an example. Yes. So the correct answer here is D. We know three examples of enriched media. Blood agar, chocolate agar and Loftus. So all of them are there in the option. Blood, chocolate, Loftus. But bile is not an example of enriched. So you should know the examples, exact examples. Correct answer here is D. This is the next question. All of the following are examples of selective media except. Selective medias are the solid medias, you know, except. I have told you six examples of selective. I'm not repeating them. You know the examples. Potassium telluride, DCA, LJ or nutrient. Very easy question. Baby question. If you don't know the examples, even also by common sense, you can crack this question. How nutrient agar can be? Nutrient is the basic agar, na? How it can be selective? Basic. It should contain something extra, something added ingredients. So correct answer among them is D. Correct answer among them is D. Rest all DCA, LGA. You can see the examples there. This is the next question in front of you. Which of the following enrichment media? Enrichment is the liquid media. Is preferred to grow Vibrio. Is preferred to grow Vibrio. I have told you three examples. All three are there. Selenite F growth, tetrathionate growth and alkaline peptone water. You tell me. So which is exacting the growth? So for Vibrio, it is alkaline peptone water. So the correct answer here is C. I have told you alkaline peptone water for Vibrio. Selenite F growth for dysentery bacilli. and tetrathionate growth for Salmonella shigella. So all of them are example. All of them are examples of enrichment media only. But alkaline peptone water is for Vibrio. So learn the name of bacteria also. Again and again, I was telling you. So that is how the first this chapter is completed. Now time is limited, so I cannot continue the next chapter. But yeah, just a second. Give me a second. Let me move ahead. So let me announce the next class. So thank you very much. Next class is after 10 minutes. After 10 minutes at 10:15 sharp, I will teach you pharmacology. I will teach you pharmacodynamics today. Don't dare to miss it. So after 10 minutes, please join me there. Don't forget to give your feedback to me for detailed lectures. Install an Academy Learners app from the Play Store. Go to the NEET PG category. Search my name, Dr. Priyanka Sachdev, and follow my profile link. You will get a list of lectures along with the notes PDF. For that, you will require a code. The lectures are free, but the code is Sachdev10. That is S-A-C-H-D-E-V. Sachdev10 is the code. And there are two types of subscriptions on the Plus platform. Plus subscription and Iconic subscription. On Plus, you will get access to Unacademy lectures only. On Iconic, you will, along with Unacademy, you will get access to Prep Ladder also. And this is a limited time offer. I guess the offer is over. You can try, but I guess the offer is over. Only for limited first 500 students, we have launched this offer. But the, I think the 500 students are done. But maybe if not today, it will last. Today it will last. So if you want to take the subscription, take it today only. And you will get these prizes if you use my code Sachdev10. So it is a limited time offer. Please get most of it. If you are thinking of taking a Plus subscription, that is the most beneficial thing in your preparation. Don't miss this opportunity. Please take the subscription on this offer. Today is the last day. And these are the batches for NEXT, for FMG, for INICT on the Plus platform. You can take the advantage of them. These are the prizes of Plus and Iconic for various subscriptions available to us for NEET PG, FMG, INICT, all of them. And if you use the code Sachdev10, you will get 10% discount from tomorrow. And today it is more than 10% discount on all these offers. So please make the use of it. Okay, see you. I'm ending this lecture. Join me after 5 minutes for pharmacology. Bye-bye. Don't dare to miss out pharmacology. I'm ending this.